Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss a practical application of refraction that we can see in our daily life a lot. As we know that light enables us to see an object, similarly here in this case, if there is an object placed at some depth in water, then the light rays coming from this object when enter into human eye, then that person will be capable of seeing that object. Okay, so the light ray that is coming normally to the surface of water will go undeviated, as we know that whenever light passes from one medium to another, normally along the normal, then in that case it pass undeviated along the same path. But there are rays which are coming to the surface at a certain angle. For example, here I have drawn OB, which is a ray that is coming to this interface at an angle I, means the incident angle that this ray OB is making with the normal is I. So it get refracted, and it get refracted such that as it is moving from denser to rarer medium, so we know that whenever light ray moves from a denser to rare medium, it bends away from the normal. So its actual path is like this, while it gets bent away from the normal. So angle of refraction that we get will be greater than angle of incidence, and after refraction we get the ray BC. So if a person is observing this object at point D, that person will see this object at its actual depth, because the whole distance is covered by the ray. But if a person is observing this object from point C, then the ray entering to the eye of that person is BC, which is appearing to be coming from I, not from O. This ray is coming from O actually, but since it get deviated, so it appeared to be coming from I, and because of that, person will be capable of see the image of the object, not the object exactly. So it seems that the object is placed here, not at this point. Then this depth AI, we call it as apparent depth, because it is appearing to the person which is at point C only, but the actual depth is AO. So real depth means the actual depth of the object that we can see from just above that object. उस ऑब्जेक्ट के लोकेशन से जस्ट अबव अगर हम हैं अलोंग द नॉर्मल, ओनली देन वी कैन सी इट एट इट्स एक्चुअल डेप्थ, दैट इज कॉल्ड रियल डेप्थ. बट इफ वी आर एट सम अदर पॉइंट, देन द रे कमिंग टू द आई विल अपियर टू बी कमिंग फ्रॉम सम अदर पॉइंट एट अ शॉर्टर हाइट और अ शॉर्टर डेप्थ. सो दिस डेप्थ इज कॉल्ड एपरेंट डेप्थ. आई एम मार्किंग हियर, this depth AI is called apparent depth, and we are going to find a relation between real depth and apparent depth for the object O. So what we have here is an object at O whose real depth is denoted by AO. So this is the real depth, but person at point C, so but from point C it appears to be at point I. So if the object appears to be at point I, although it's at point O, but it appears that it is placed at I, so apparent depth of the object is AI, where I denotes the position of virtual image of that object. This is not real, this is the position of virtual image of the object O. And now we want to find the relation between the real depth AO and the apparent depth AI. इनके बीच का रिलेशन हमें कैलकुलेट करना है. सिंस रिफ्रैक्शन इज गोइंग ऑन, सो वी आर गोइंग टू अप्लाई स्नेल्स लॉ. बाय यूजिंग स्नेल्स लॉ वी कैन राइट दैट सिंस द रे इज मूविंग फ्रॉम वॉटर टू एयर, सो वॉटर विल एक्ट एज मीडियम वन एंड एयर विल एक्ट एज मीडियम 2. So we have 1 mu 2 means we have W mu A is equal to sine of angle of incidence upon sine of angle of refraction. Now from the diagram, this angle of incidence is equal to AOB. That means W mu A is equal to sine of angle AOB, and angle of refraction is equal to, this is angle of refraction, which is equal to angle AIB also, because these are normal, both parallel, and this ray is cutting the two lines. So R is also equal to angle AIB. So I am writing it here, sine angle AIB. Now by using simple trigonometric formula, sine AOB like this, in this triangle AOB, we can write sine of angle I as perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So it will be AB upon BO. This is perpendicular and this is hypotenuse for angle I. Similarly, in triangle AIB, sine of angle AIB can be written as perpendicular upon hypotenuse, means perpendicular is AB and hypotenuse is BI. So AB upon BI. Now if we solve it, we get BI upon BO. The term AB will be cancelled out from numerator and denominator. This shows that A, W mu A, we have W mu A, right? W mu A is equal to BI upon BO. Now the size of the pupil of human eye, right? Size of pupil of human eye is small, and that's why these two rays OA and OB, or the BC that is coming after refraction, will enter human eye. These two rays simultaneously will enter human eye only if the position of A and B is close to each other. So the rays coming from object O both will enter human eye or the pupil if the two are very close to each other. So we are considering that since the size of pupil is small, so both rays will enter only if B and A are close. Since we are considering that B and A are close, so this AB distance is very small. If this AB distance is very small, then we can write this BI approximately is equal to AI. If this distance is very small, then BI approximately is equal to AI, and BO approximately is equal to AO if the two points are very close. This is the consideration. So I am writing here that BI is approximately is equal to AI and BO is approximately is equal to AO. So from this relation, W mu A will be AI upon AO, right? Or we can write A mu W, that means the refractive index of water with respect to air, is equal to AO upon AI. That means refractive index is equal to, AO was the real depth and AI was apparent depth. So this is the relation between real depth and apparent depth, and we can also state it like apparent depth that we wanted to find, that apparent depth is equal to real depth upon refractive index. This is how we can find the apparent depth of an object in the medium. Now, since we know that refractive index of any medium is greater than unity, means if we exclude vacuum ko chhod ke, if we have any other medium, then its refractive index will going to be greater than unity, and because of that, since it will be greater than 1, apparent depth will always be less than real depth, and that's why that object will appear to be raised. We see it at a lower depth comparatively what is its actual depth, because refractive index other than vacuum of all the medium is greater than 1. That's why apparent depth is always less than real depth. Now there come a new term called normal shift. So this is normal shift. Means your object was actually here and it appeared to be at point I. So this shift is called normal shift and we denote it by small d. So we can calculate this normal shift by taking the difference of real depth and apparent depth that we are going to do now. So normal shift is equal to, it is denoted by d, and it is equal to the difference between real depth and apparent depth. That means real depth was AO and apparent depth was AI. And we just find the value of apparent depth in terms of real depth, and it is equal to, apparent depth is equal to real depth upon refractive index. So it can be written as AO upon mu, and when we take common we get this normal shift d is equal to AO 1 minus 1 upon mu. This is the formula for normal shift. If the total depth, the initial or the real depth was t, then we can write it as d is equal to t 1 minus 1 upon mu. So this was the mathematical formula for normal shift, and we can define normal shift as the height through which, it is the height through which an object appear to be raised. So we can write it as the height through which an object appears to be raised in a denser medium. It only happens when the object is in denser medium and we are viewing it from a rare medium. So it appears to be raised in a denser medium by some height, and that height is called, this is called normal shift. Okay, this is the definition for normal shift, the height raised or the shift in the location that appears to us because of the denser medium, that is called the normal shift, and it is equal to the difference between real depth and the apparent depth of that object. So that's it for the video. For further videos, stay tuned and keep studying. Thank you.